No, the rings, the, it's the rings, the triple whole, chain.
The whole rings thing.
Rings to triple chain to...
I hate it all.
Poor thing.
Scroll?
Not scroll.
Mm-hmm. Get somebody else to do it.
Get somebody else to do it.
He's just so up close and personal.
Yeah.
Oh, trumpet! Or... Still no. Just no. Aww. See, I don't want no nigga that I'm saying ah. I don't
want to
say ah.
He look like he bites.
Not he a munch. Num, num, num.
Okay. Like, y'all are ridiculous. What's the point of being on there if you guys aren't going to give anyone a chance?
We are giving them a chance. They're just not it.
They're not worthy of a chance.
That part.
Let me see.
And what are you going to do?
Let's see.
Oh, because you could do better.
What dating profile is this anyway?
This is Hinge.
Okay. Here we go. Zach. He's 28, 6'2", from LA, smokes and drinks sometimes. Okay, and wants kids but doesn't have any.
But it says he's a club promoter.
Negative.
Okay, you know what? Y'all, I can't.
That just means bitches. No.
I bet I can find some quality men that might actually make an impression on you.
And how are you going to do that?
Let me take over your profile. Reach out to some of these men and actually set you up on a date. And it might be somebody that's not your type but end up being your type. You don't know, but let's do it. I think I can pull it off.
I don't know. Like, that sounds a little...
Unhinged. That's what it sounds like.
That's it. Unhinged is what we'll call it. Are you down?
I'm down. Let's do it.
Welcome to Unhinged.
Oh my God, that's so unhinged.
Hey everyone, I'm Alexis Powell, aka Lex B for Real. 3 weeks ago, my friend Morgan made it very clear that she doesn't step outside of the box when it comes to online dating. So I decided to take over her Hinge profile and set her up on 5 different blind dates. Here's how it will work. The dates will be planned and executed by yours truly. The guys will be able to see what Morgan looks like, but she'll have no idea who they are or what the date will be until they meet in person for the very first time. But don't worry, Morgan will be given one clue to make sure she plans accordingly. The purpose of this was to see if Morgan can build a genuine connection outside of her usual type. At the end of the series, Morgan will be able to choose one guy to further explore with. Could this be a match made in heaven, or would this be a total waste? Stay tuned to find out, because you are now watching Unhinged.
Throw this rap, she knows she wants some of that. When she move her body, she gonna have a nigga running back. Throw this rap, she knows she wants some of that.
Hey, babe, can you come here for a sec?
Hey, baby.
Hello. Come pop a squat.
What's up?
Yeah, so you know how I'm like supposed to be taking over Morgan's profile and stuff? Mm-hmm. Find her men to go on a date with.
Yeah.
A blind date, that is.
I thought I could use your help, you know?
Don't do that, because I think I'm pretty good. Like, I'm an expert in finding good, nice face men. Because I feel like that's what it's all about. I mean, we don't really know much, you know, just by looking at their profile.
Yeah, but you can get a good sense of who the person is from their profile, more than just their looks.
Yeah.
How they answer those prompts.
I'm, like, trying to get guys that are, like, her type, but not her type, too. Because I feel like she goes for the same type of, like, tall, dark, handsome. So, like, I'm trying to, like, stray away from that.
Yeah. You want to give her some people that you know off the bat that she's going to like, and then some people that might be a little bit out of her comfort zone, or someone that she wouldn't normally swipe on herself, but is still a good candidate.
Right. Let me see what we got so far.
Okay.
Okay, so, like, him. He just popped up.
Yeah.
Okay. But he looks
really
cool.
Young.
Oh, what, how is he?
26.
She's 24. And he has hair.
She did say she likes hair.
He's 6'0". He's a business account executive. They might got some money. See, like, I like that. So,
That's the criteria for you.
I mean, yeah, because I also want to choose guys that look like they'll participate. Yeah.
How are they supposed to know, like, this is legit or, like, that we're not Morgan messaging us? See, so I had Morgan send me a video of, like, her explaining that we're doing this, or, like, that I'm taking over her profile. So okay. I put it on her profile already.
Hey, y'all. My name is Morgan, and I'm here to let y'all in on plot twist. So my friends actually asked me to be a part of their new blind dating series on YouTube, probably because I'm the only single motherfucker out the group, but you know what, that's fine. I thought it'd be fun. So if you're single and interested, go ahead and send me a message and they're actually gonna take it from there. They don't work for any TV network or anything like that. This is literally just for shits and giggles. So, you know, if you think I'm a little cute or you want to have a little fun, go ahead and send me a message. And maybe I'll find the one. Who knows?
She's so cute. I like that. I was like, that was perfect. So, yes. So when I DM them, I'm just going to say, I'm going to be like, hey, there was some hard eyes in there.
Okay. We can chill on the hard eyes. We're not trying to make
I'm just going to put three.
One is fine.
No, you don't know men. You gotta be nice, babe. Like, I feel like hard eyes and emojis are, like, enticing. Like, I don't want to just say, hey, like me. Like, I would say, hey, with an exclamation point.
How many men's DMs have you slid into in your life?
None, but
please,
what I'm saying.
Just trust me on this.
Okay. So, hey, smiley face. Check up. Why do I keep saying check? Watch the first video on my profile.
She's definitely going to pull them in. We just need them to participate. I mean, want to go on a date.
Yes.
Yeah, boys' problem nowadays. Like, they don't actually want to go on a date.
But let alone be filmed.
Exactly. Let alone be filmed. But that's the good and the beauty about this is that I'm setting everything up. So now you just have to come and get you a catch.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, period.
I have faith in you, babe.
You have faith in me? Yes. You think you can lead me to it and I get my thing on with these guys?
I meant, like, you know, be DMing. I'm probably
yes,
DMing
I'll lead you to it to get your thing on with these guys.
Don't do that.
I'll lead you to it. Let me know if you need any more help.
Love you.
Love you too.
Like a big arm.
Like my bitch natural with little makeup. Young niggas, we just really got our cake up. We don't got so we don't ever get no tape up. To the head, nigga, just like.
Okay, y'all, today is finally the day. The first day of the series, and I'm super excited. After countless hours of DMing and swiping through profiles, we finally have our 5 men, and I can't wait for y'all to meet them. In a minute, we're gonna head over to Morgan House and give her a clue on today's date. Remember, at the end of the series, Morgan will choose one guy to go on a second date with. Also, be sure to leave a comment on what you think about the dates for a chance to win a $100 gift card. But before we go, I just realized that you guys don't even know who Morgan is. So, let's meet Morgan.
Hey y'all, I'm Morgan, I'm 24 years old, and I'm from Plainfield, New Jersey, and I guess I'm ready to get unhinged. I guess I'm doing unhinged because I'm just one of those people that will just say like, fuck it, and just try anything. So I'm here, we're locked in, we're going on these dates, and I'm actually very excited for it, but I will say that I think that I'm gonna learn a lot about just judging people, especially coming from a relationship that was so long and I thought I knew what I wanted, and now that I'm dating, I'm like, wait, what actually do I want? Like, what am I into? What type of guy do I like? Like, what's my type? And I feel like I typically go for like the same kind of guy, so it's gonna be very interesting just to entertain people that I would've just like swiped on, I guess. So maybe somebody will blow me away who I would just never think to not look at, but be with. My friends would describe me as just very unserious. Like, I'm usually always smiling, I'm usually always laughing, I like to have a good time. I'm not really funny, like, I'm not gonna have you cracking up, but like, we're gonna have a good time. And then in terms of relationships, I think that they would say that I am quick to fall in love. Like, I'm a big softy. I kind of like to give off this kind of hard approach, but inside, you know, at my core, I'm a lover girl. So hopefully these men will just blow me away and sweep me off my feet, and you know, maybe we'll fall in love and get married and have babies or something like that. But if not, you know, at least it's a good experience and I made some form of connection, even if it's just like a new friend in LA. Maybe it'll be a match made in heaven. Stay tuned on
I just feel like one of these guys, you're definitely gonna make a connection with.
Okay.
Do you think you're hard to get? Like, you think, like, nobody
would love to impress you? I would love to think I'm hard to get. I'm not easy. But I feel like they all have a little one up because it's like you planned the date. So,
yeah.
Yeah. So I gotta really see what their personality is.
Yeah, you know, I feel like I did the hard part, you know? Right. Everybody just gotta show up and do what they do. They just gotta impress you. Mm-hmm. I guess you gotta impress them. Okay. They don't even know you too. So that's the funny thing about this is that all they got to see was pictures from you and hear your voice. So now it's like, you know, can you make an impression on them? I feel like you're good.
Oh, you're not nervous about that. Oh, okay. My fault.
But okay, I'm excited. You know what I'm saying? I already, you know, I've met everybody. I'm just ready to see how everybody clashes together. So
okay,
can't wait to see who you'll pick at the end. But let's take a little shot, you feel me? Let's get everybody. Let's
not
get
the jitters out. Wow. Jameson is crazy.
It's my favorite, you know?
I'll pour you up.
Jameson.
Don't do that. not too much. But okay, you feel me? First date is
first
up.
First date to Unhinged. Nasty. It's your favorite though, so fix your face.
I mean, don't do that.
It's your
favorite. So. Don't do that. Mm-hmm. But okay, I need to go. Mm-hmm. These people ready to see the first guy, so.
Yeah,
you ready to see the first guy too? They want to see him more than you.
Yeah, okay.
But let me go.
Wait, what was the clue?
Oh, that was the clue. All right, now. Love you.
No.
What does that mean? I got to go.
So this could be anything.
What's up, everybody? It's Win, the biggest Win from Los Angeles, California. 25 years of age.
That's my slap, that's my guy, that's my road dog. We fuck bitches, we get money, feel like Sosa. I'm selling this pack, you know that it's gay.
My last relationship was like 2-3 years ago. I mean, I really don't have no type. I mean, I'm just, like, it was beautiful. If she's doing too much, you know, I can pass it to the next one. What makes me stand out from other guys? I mean, I'm just me. How would my friends describe it? Man, him.
When I'm making a bet, told me don't cheat and I did it again. Dropped the hose, had to pick up the pen. Do what I want and you do what you can. Look at your bitch and I know that I slid it. Got you some paper, just know that they hate it. Keep it 100, just know I can't fake it.
Hello.
How you doing?
Hi.
Come on, come around.
Nice. Oh, handshake, yeah, not a hug. Doing? Okay, all right.
How you doing?
I'm good.
That's good.
What are you making drinks?
Yeah.
You a mixologist or something, or you don't know what you're doing?
I mean, we're gonna find out if I know what I'm doing.
Okay.
You?
You know, I went to a class once
and then go back. But it was a lot of fun.
How
was it? It was fine.
Okay, we making drinks. I feel like that's right up my alley. Everybody knows I'm usually making drinks. So I should be good at this. I'm not really worried.
Okay, so what are we making? Take it away.
Pick left or right, which one you want?
Left.
I look like you got tequila.
Okay, okay, okay.
How you feel about this?
I like tequila.
I bet you do. Okay, cool. So you gotta make tequila, all right? So
okay.
What the tequila, I'm assuming that we're using this fresh size, right? here we go. Okay, we got this.
Mm-hmm.
All right, and then you gonna help me? Come on, help
me out. Hey, you were taking the lead. Everything's okay.
Yeah, okay, so you got that. Okay. You got orange juice. Orange juice right here. So let's get everything out right here.
Oh, there's steps. There's ice somewhere? Oh.
Yeah, ice.
Stand up. Let me take this seriously.
I feel like I'm gonna be blushing this entire time. Like, I can't. I'm glad that I'm standing next to him so I don't have to stare at him, because I'll just be staring.
What do you do for work?
So I have my own gym.
Ooh, cool. Okay.
Yeah, so I help people get their body goals. You know, whoever want to be sexier. That's who I work with.
Is your gym? Like, wow.
Winning Fitness.
He seemed like he'd be working out for real. And I'm not trying to embarrass myself. But I go to work out with him, I'm trying to look cute. Real cute and dainty.
Well, okay. I'm making two, right? You should double it?
Yeah, go ahead, double it.
Well, you're drinking some, right?
Yeah, I'm
drinking
them.
Okay.
What's next?
You got it. You got the next one.
Do I got to count for this one, too?
Yeah.
3 ounces.
Do what your heart desires.
That's You got this one, right? Backside.
Oh, it says take a spoon.
See? Okay. Gotta read a little bit.
Clearly, I never went back.
Yeah, I can see. Well, you went for a day?
Just a day. It was cool. Like, the setup was cool. Good. Okay,
I don't know if y'all use a spoon, right?
Okay.
All right. Let's get to the backside of the spoon.
Maybe we just, like, shake it and see.
I know I said I knew what I was doing with these drinks, but I feel like I'm usually just winging it at home or just pouring a shot. So.
Bro, okay, so maybe I'll go to your gym, but
maybe
not your bar. Maybe. Not your bar.
You the one who's leading.
Leading? This was we did step bar? One and step two. Yeah. Step two. This is a 50-50 kind of ordeal here.
Sound like excuses if you guys.
Wow.
You want sugar?
I actually don't like anything. You want something sugar on the rim?
Nah, I'm gonna take it out.
Take it out.
Okay. I talk to him. To the
head. It's not bad.
It was good.
It's not strong.
I like how you had like a little dash. It gave me some of grapefruit.
You know, made it a little sexy.
You know. Anyways, what do you do?
I work at a marketing agency.
Okay, how's that?
Interesting, kind of.
In what way?
I do data analytics, so
okay. It's
not that interesting, though.
In LA, people are always like, just be like artsy and like just like do something you love. I'm like, LA is expensive. I'm gonna do what's paying me. Like right now, that's the concern.
I gotta tell you, I like your outfit.
Thank you. I like your work.
Thank you. I mean, I see a little blue.
You know, I kind of manifested this. Like, I knew this was going to happen.
A little touch. Got the nails to match, too.
You know.
Doing it. Okay. I see. You mind if you pass me a napkin?
Yeah. Oh, wait. These are not.
Yeah, a napkin.
Yeah,
right there.
Well, let me get you a napkin. But what is this?
I don't know. What is it?
Ooh. Oh, whoa. Oh, okay. It's empty. Oh, they're like truth or drink cards.
I was trying to see what these shots was for. It makes sense now.
Oh, the truth or drink. Monogamy or polyamory?
Poly.
Hmm.
I mean, I'm Nigerian.
Okay.
Yeah, we're like, you feel me, had this conversation. But yeah, I'm Nigerian.
No, never had that. Yeah. Just met you today, sir.
You know, anyways, but yeah, I'm Nigerian. I mean, it's part of my culture.
Okay.
We're starting off strong, you know, he had me in the first half.
I feel like a lot of people get into it for selfish reasons.
Okay. It's like the Lauren London interview.
Yeah.
Okay.
um, my reason is just more just like, first of all, I would never get in that situation with inviting multiple women into my space if I couldn't do what I could do as a man.
Okay. For them. Okay.
Because it's already hard enough to take care of one girl. I've taken multiple. It's hard. You get me? Don't get me wrong.
So we're talking like multiple wives?
I mean, I would prefer only two.
Okay.
Realistically, if I'm being honest. Two.
Okay.
I don't want too many because
that's like too many. Like two kids? Two houses, two families? Like
no, I would just join together.
Oh, like everybody's here.
Everybody's
oh, here. Everybody's family. Here.
Yeah, I want 10 kids. Okay. I want a big, big, big family.
10 kids? 10 kids is insanity. Like, I'm really just trying to hold my composure right now.
So it's like the Drake wedding video.
That was very great. I was inspired.
Or would
by
you
Drake.
Marry just one and then maybe meet someone else, or would you wait?
I mean, I would rather I could be with one girl. That's fine.
Okay. But your options are open.
Oh yeah,
you're not limiting yourself.
Yeah, never limiting myself.
Never limiting yourself. Sky's the limit,
so, you know, okay. We're gonna keep shooting.
How does that work for you?
It's been great. I mean, you know,
how do girls receive that information?
I mean, it's cool though, because my thing is like I'm not forcing nobody to be here regardless.
True.
So I'm telling them straightforward, like how I feel, what I'm looking for. I mean, if they would, they would. If they not, man, it's okay. You feel me? I'm not the guy for you. You feel me? So that's fine. You can find you another man. You feel me? That's cool.
How do you introduce that?
I let the conversation naturally come to it. I'm not about to sit here and throw that. Oh,
by the way.
I let it naturally come. You feel me? Because, you know, I don't force nothing.
But no one's like tripped out on you, like, not you have a girl sometimes?
I mean, they always gonna say something. But I mean, at the end of the day, it's just more just like, okay, what's next after that? Then?
Okay.
But I'm gonna let you know. I ain't gonna play. I ain't got no
So what is Pops doing? Or like your dad?
My dad?
Yeah.
My dad, he African, you know, he Nigerian. He do what he do.
He do like, I'm just asking, like, how is your setup? Like,
I mean, you know, he with my mom.
Okay.
They're happy together. They getting older, so I mean, my dad ain't really with the games.
Okay, fair.
Like that, but I mean, you know, it's just, you know, it's part of the. My dad really didn't do as much.
If your dad didn't do it, then where are you getting this from? Talking about your culture. I'm on to you.
This question is for you.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so we got truth or drink.
Okay, all right.
So we got fuck, marry, or kill.
All right.
We got my boy Michael B. Jordan. We got Kofi. We got Drizzy, Drake. Okay.
Okay, so I feel like if we've seen the movie Girls Trip, we're gonna fuck Kofi for sure.
Okay.
100%.
Okay.
And we will marry Michael B. Jordan because he's definitely like he was a good boyfriend. He was showing out, he rented the whole aquarium out, he was doing his thing.
Drizzy can't do that either.
He's just like, I don't think we would mesh well.
Okay.
You're a little corny.
Okay. No. Too corny for you? You don't think he might be Jordan?
He might be, but he's Michael B. Jordan. I can't ask you that one back. Truth or drink.
Okay.
Fuck, marry, kill. We got Beyonce, Rihanna, and Lori Harvey.
Man, this is a hard one. It's a good one right here.
I don't know who we're killing.
I'm probably I kill Lori. Gotta get rid of Lori. She, I'm just gonna get rid of Lori. Okay.
Yeah.
It's fine though. I mean, nothing against her. You know, Lori, call me. You feel me? But right now, just.
That's just how Lori calls you. You do say
you do. You wouldn't, you know. Anyway, okay. Exactly. Anyways, kill Lori.
Yeah.
Probably dog Rihanna. So I'm gonna hit Rihanna.
Okay.
I'll marry Beyonce. This is Beyonce. So.
Okay, I think that's a pretty standard answer.
Yeah, I mean,
I think that's what most people would do.
I think so. My turn.
Yes.
Have you ever messed with a significant other's friend?
I have not ever messed with a significant other's friend. Actually, they like his friends have like DM'd me before.
Oh, you got one of them?
Yeah. Okay. Like, that shit, like, is actually, like, super disrespectful.
No, that's real. No,
yeah.
That happens.
It, like, makes me so mad.
No, it does. It's crazy.
Yeah, like, that, like, just happened to me with one of my, like, exes, basically.
Oh.
I just had to, like, screenshot
my
it. Yeah, I'm like, well, one, it's like, different if that's how you move.
But I feel like if you're assuming that I move that way, like I feel like for you to go that far to approach me is like you assuming that I move that way. And now you're like questioning my character.
Yeah, most definitely.
Yeah, I can't do that. What about you?
I mean, not by choice. Not by choice. I didn't decide to make that decision. You
blacked out?
No, not even that. It was just more just like, you feel me? It just happened. It wasn't my choice though. But it was just like, you talking about, wait, you talking about cheating? Let me just make sure. Are you talking about cheating or are you just talking about?
It doesn't have to be cheating. Like, y'all could have been broken up, but this is still like your ex or your significant other's friend. Like, you know.
You know who their friends are.
I mean, you know who you're talking about right now.
I shouldn't have been with her. I mean, clearly we there were just for a reason. You feel me?
Oh, y'all were like,
nah, we date or anything. Just happened.
Yeah, just an entanglement.
I mean, yeah, if that's what you want to call it. But yeah, I mean, shit, it happened. I mean, it's just. Nothing new to it. Shit happens, you feel me? You know. Damn.
You gotta take a shot to that or not?
Do I have to
take a shot? We both have to take a shot.
You can take a shot to that trifling stuff. Yeah. No judgment, though. No judgment. No, take the shot. Take the shot.
I bet.
Yeah.
You might be for the streets.
Have you ever dated outside your race?
Yeah.
What race is? White women? No offense to them, lovely ladies, the whites.
I've never personally like been in a relationship with a white woman.
Oh.
I've dated, like, you know, when I'll, you know, have fun and stuff like that. I've done that before. But dating wise, used to be my queens, my black women.
Ooh, Grand Rising kind of guy.
Or my Latinas.
Ooh.
You know,
they have me in a chokehold. They have me in a little chokehold.
My black women got me in a chokehold.
Okay, okay.
Latinas not that far. You feel me? But, you know, I don't discriminate. You know, I love all type of races. I ain't got no type.
That's good for him.
What's the most shallow reason why you stopped dating someone?
I don't really think it's shallow. I haven't dated like too many people like that, I guess, but
I don't know what that is.
I stopped talking to somebody because I don't think that's shallow though. I didn't. Okay, he didn't clean his bathroom.
Okay.
What about you?
Her
wig was lifting. What you like?
It's crazy you said hair because it was because of hair. It was really because I didn't really like the braids that she had. So I really stopped talking to her. But I mean, I'm not against braids.
What braids did she have?
At that time she had, it was like individuals in a sense. I'm not really a big fan of individuals. It's very chop. To me, it's childish. But it's okay. If that's what you want, though.
What do you mean
no
by
problem.
Individual? Like box braids?
Individual, small.
That's what you got in your head right now?
Nah, these are twists.
Yeah, but I'm saying strand. Like that size?
Nah, it's smaller.
Oh, tiny like the ones. Micro. Yes. Oh,
I wasn't
that's
really
intense. That is
very,
intense.
Very, very, very. Yeah. I had to pass on it. Nothing against it. That's I mean, intense. I was messing with her and then she got it and I had to pass on it.
Oh, that's literally a temporary hairstyle.
I know. Then when she dropped I started talking back to her.
Okay. She can bounce back.
I just had to get out the. I couldn't do the braids. This just wasn't my style. Like, I'm not a big fan on braids, but my thing is just like, if you make it look good, I'm with it.
Okay, you
but
like that?
Good on it. I mean, yeah, I'm cool with all
that's
that.
Been awkward.
Nah, you got. I mean, you see what I got on my hair. I can't discriminate.
Okay. I mean, I don't change it too much. But I might put a little spiral curl in there.
Never have I ever cheated on a significant other.
I've cheated before. Sure. Yeah, I mean, yeah. I was young. I mean, shit, I'm 25 now. So I mean, sure. I didn't have a couple.
I'm laughing, reflecting. Jesus.
I mean, shit, it's all funny games.
Somewhere.
Nah,
it's all funny games.
She happy. They gotta be happy now. Anyways, but yeah, I've done. You feel me? I was young. I mean, I probably won't never cheat again. It's more. I would never cheat again. It's just more just like I wasn't having communication.
Okay.
I wasn't talking. I wasn't explaining. I wasn't letting know what really the situation was looking like. So I was letting her decide on
how. Like you could have just broke up with her.
Well, I could have. No. Real talk. Could have broken up with her. But at the same time, I wasn't saying God that I am today. It's two different people. Yeah. So, I mean,
you know. Everybody has a cheating story.
Everybody done what they're supposed to do. You feel me?
Everybody's cheated somewhere.
You gotta fall sometimes. Somehow. That's all. I'm gonna fall sometimes. It happens.
Yeah, when was the last time you cheated? Like 2 days ago.
See. I'm not in a relationship right now, so nothing's
okay, considered cheating. Okay,
I would say probably, I mean, would you count on and off? And be,
I mean, if you were off, no, I hate when girls do that.
I mean, yeah, girls. Anyways. I'll probably say with my second to the last girl, there's just a bunch of shit going on, you feel me?
Bunch of shit.
Yeah, I was new to college.
She was new to college. To do an open relationship when I went to college.
That shit ain't flying.
I was like 17. Let's be in an open relationship.
That shit is not flying. At least on my end. I don't know to you. Oh, y'all.
You can't do an open relationship? You just want everybody to be in a relationship together.
Yeah, because my thing is like, I don't.
You don't think an open relationship would be better?
I mean,
you can leave one. Let's be honest.
I'm
irritated.
Everybody's in open relationships if y'all not really like married, if you're being honest.
Fair.
If we're being honest. So that's the reason why it's like open relationship, you're already in one. So okay. What's the point of even totalizing open relationship with everybody?
I feel like there's more like trust.
I'm not trusting like, I'm sitting here to go and smash no other guy other than me.
You can have rules. Well, all my rules got broken. And like
that's what I'm saying. What's the point of having an open relationship if you know me? Might as well just do poly.
I think poly works better for men.
No.
For sure.
If she like girls,
you would be my second boyfriend?
Now, I would never be with a guy, but I mean, like I said, if you like girls, I like girls. Why not? You feel me? If you like girls, I like girls, you might as well bring that to the situation. If you open to it. Like I said.
Can your girl go on dates without you? Or would you be upset?
Hell yeah, go ahead.
You paying up?
Go ahead.
Okay.
Whatever y'all need, go ahead.
Down in the valley where girls get naked.
Okay, I mean, shit. Then I got to know you. I got to know you. You gave me a better, good understanding of you. So.
Okay, okay.
Let's finish off with a toast. To a winning Sunday. You know what I mean?
A winning Sunday to the biggest.
How the day was? The day was good. Morgan was great. Enjoyed her. She was cool people. Was Morgan everything I expected? She actually was. I mean, like I said, I didn't expect really much from her, but I just expected that me and her would connect. And that's exactly what it did. You feel me? Good vibe, good energy. She's great. What was my favorite moment? Seeing Morgan walk to the table. You feel me? Check her out, so you know that was probably my favorite moment right there. Do I think she will pick me for another date? I mean, why not? I mean, I don't think anybody else competing with me, so I mean, yeah, why not? If I was to go on a second date, what would I plan for the next Netflix and chill? I'm just playing. shit, I don't know, we probably do something fun. Probably do like, you know, some arcade, some games, you know, some shit cool. Not try to keep too formal, just, you know, fun.
Yeah, I'm feeling pretty good. This is a good date. My first impression, so I like hair, so I saw the hair. I feel like that's my go-to. He was very like presentable, like he looked very clean, like he really like tried today.
I'm definitely nervous before any day. I'm always like, what am I gonna say? That's why I think I like really appreciate when men come to first dates like very confident and just like overextending themselves and making sure that like you're comfortable. That's always just noted. I feel like that carries into the relationship as it continues on. So he was definitely one of those guys who just like tried to make me feel comfortable and kind of took charge and stuff.
Following this guy, I think the expectations are a little higher now.